this way. Very unusual for me to have him on the left. Green screen is amazing today, as I can see. How are you, Kretzer?
I'm doing really good today, Hinduman. It's always a pleasure to join you. And we've got a lot of games we could cast, a lot of games we're going to cast. I can't wait to see what happens in this first North American Challengers Cup. It's really going to set the pace because right now there are 60-plus teams.
Right.
And honestly, we have some ideas, but we don't know who's going to perform and who's going to be on top of that humongous pile. This is going to set the tone for the rest of the Challengers Cup and potentially for the rest of the year, as these teams from the Challengers Cup can qualify in through the wild card to get to playoffs and eventually World Championships.
That's right. And on top of that, they do get the opportunity to win money every single week. And it also gives them the potential for the pro teams to look over them and scout some of these players out and go, hey, this guy's not that bad. Maybe we should pick him up for our team in the pro league.
Yeah, looking at the pro league so far, there are a lot of teams doing well. A lot of teams that just have little problems. Sometimes teams choose to address those problems with roster changes. Not necessarily saying that's the way to go, but it is an option. And honestly, pulling players out of challengers is standard in pretty much all esports. We'll see if that does happen later in the season, but we'll keep you apprised of that if any of our notable challengers players do get sort of abducted to the pro league.
To the pro league, yep.
But let's head into our first match in just a few minutes. It's going to be Team Zodiac versus Snapchat Gaming. Team Zodiac, I'm not super familiar with, but Snapchat Gaming is a team that we've seen in Smite Central's Battle for Valhalla, and they're honestly pretty strong.
I hope they're all grills. That's all I'm saying. Because with a team name like Snapchat Gaming, if they're randomly sending each other pics of themselves, I'm a bit concerned for their morals and what they've been up to in the time. But Winterpix bans Mercury banned out by Zodiac straight away. Not a surprise.
Yeah, it's going to be a new ban from Snapchat. Team Zodiac now has the option. We do see a lot of support bans. Jean-Cui is also a very, very highly contested character statistically so far in the Pro League. And just given the nature of the Challengers Cup, I expect it to mostly mimic the Pro League with maybe some variations. For example, in the Pro League, Serket is highly contested, highly banned. But here might just be a little bit too niche, a little bit too high. It's very hard to play Serket, is what I'm getting at.
I think during the first few weeks, honestly, Kret, you're going to see these teams just go for standard sort of bans you'd expect to see when you don't know what your opposition's going to play, you know?
Yeah.
So the stuff that either is going to deal with your composition that you've thought out beforehand, or the other sense of that is the fact that they just don't want to deal with that god at all because they don't know what the other team's going to play. So you'll see very generalized bans, so to speak. No real targeted bans that we'd see from the Pro League sort of thing.
Yeah, that's definitely true. It's just that Serket is banned basically against everyone in the Pro League because everyone can play her because she's so good. Said, she's very difficult, so I feel like Serket could be very, very powerful in the Challengers Cup. It's just not every team is going to have that as an option. But if a team does have a powerful Serket, they might want to keep it in their pocket because, well, the best research you can get about a team is going to be their last picks. And look at that, Serket locked in for Snapchat Gaming.
Well, Loki being picked up first by Zodiac there, Kret, and it's kind of one of those picks that can go in multiple roles. We've seen him before in the Hunter role, seen him in the jungle, seen him in the solo lane nowadays as well, even played by Game Hunter just a little bit earlier on over in the pro scene. So not a surprise to see him being picked up. So he's not really given much away from what Zodiac's game plan is here.
Yeah, definitely. He's very, very versatile, and those versatile starting picks can be very, very strong. Yanis, pretty similar. He could be mid, he could be solo. You could put him somewhere else if you really wanted to, honestly, because I feel like he's just strong enough to make something work. But Apollo, probably going to be in that Hunter role. That said, people have run jungle Apollo and solo Apollo as well. I don't expect to see that.
But the one interesting thing that's going to come out of this so far is Zodiac haven't got a support in terms... Like, we saw them pick Loki first, giving Snapchat Gaming Geb after they banned away Athena. So they're going to have a decent support build. Probably going to see a Bacchus, maybe a Kumbakana. But Bacchus and Ymir have started to rise above Kumbakana right now. Zhang being picked up by Snapchat Gaming, though, and that was that Zhang you were talking about, wasn't prioritized first like most people to expect. I expect a Nemesis ban here, though.
Yeah, Nemesis ban, because Nemesis is such a strong counter to Zhang, and Zhang without that ban is very hard to deal with. It's gonna be Hubwa, and you know, I don't hate this Hubwa ban. He just does a lot of damage, and combined with Yanis, you have two mages that, if left unattended for just a few seconds, they can kill your entire team. I also want to touch on the fact that Snapchat Gaming didn't further pressure the support from Zodiac. They banned Athena, they picked Geb, which means Zodiac is onto the third string support, and that's totally unique to the support player. It's different for everybody. We've seen Sun Wukong, we've seen Ahri, we've seen Kumbo, we've seen Ymir, etc. So banning against that third string support when you don't have knowledge of what they're going to want to pick, like Frezzy's Ymir, is just sort of throwing darts with a blindfold on. You have no idea.
With Raw being picked up by Snapchat Gaming there, they can interlace or switch up whether they're going to be solo or mid with the Zhong or the Raw. We'll see what Zodiac's going to do. Are they going to pick up a jungler here? Is Loki going to be in the solo lane? At the moment, they're hovering Cheongga. And this side where they could actually switch Raw and Jonquil around could actually pay out well for Snapchat here.
Yeah, so that Sheng'Ga is going to be an attempt at counterpicking Ra. It in the laning phase, the anti-heal can be problematic in it, but isn't necessarily a death blow. And in team fights, if Sheng'Ga can get into a good spot in terms of items and be resilient, that anti-heal can be very, very strong because Ra drops his heal and you're just like, all right, 90% healing reduction on everyone nearby. Your heal doesn't do its job. So I like the Cheongga pick. I don't necessarily like the Sobek pick. He has a lot of trouble against Geb in that Stone Shield basically removes Sobek ability to do his job. He cannot pull, he cannot tail whip against the target with that Stone Shield on, and it means in the laning phase, the aggression is limited to just targeting the Geb. That
I agree.
said, Apollo Sobek could do that.
In team fights, though, I do like the idea of having the Sobek to be able to try and peel the Jonquil off the top away from the team. You know, when he pops those ghosts and tries to wreak havoc on the team, having a Sobek there just to try and fling him out could work out for them. But then, like you said, with Geb and that shield being available, it's going to be very, very difficult for them to get the opportunity to do so. As long as Geb plays it well, then Sobek's going to have a very tough time in this one. But they're the teams right now, and looking at it on paper, Cret, who do you favor here?
You know, I think it all comes down to Snapchat's level of Serket play. I think if Team Zodiac, they've got a fairly stable composition. I expect that everyone is going to perform adequately on their characters. Serket is such a wild card, though. It's like, do you know this character? Can you get the kills? Can you snowball the game? Can you really have that assassin presence where you're sort of like Loki but with an escape? Or do you go in, miss your abilities, and then die? And you know, use your alt to get on someone's head and then die because you're standing still. So we'll see what ends up happening, and I think it's on Flawless 22 to make it happen. We're gonna head into our first round match in just a few minutes, guys. Stay tuned for Team Zodiac versus Snapchat Gaming.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back. This is game one of the North American Challenge League Cup. Team Zodiac gonna be facing off against Snapchat Gaming. We'll go through quickly where everyone's playing. We're gonna see Immolation playing Loki in the jungle for Team Zodiac, Thug Nasty on Apollo in this duo lane, Deathwish on Yharnes in the mid, Hook MM on Cheongga in the solo, and Kiwi Tiger on Sobek as the support. And Snapchat Gaming, correct, what have we got?
Snapchat Gaming, their team leader Eclipsium, jumping ahead of the rest of his team on ROM, will be playing your dual lane Hunter. He'll be supported by Wubba, aka Met Yankee, on Geb, Flawless 22 in the jungle on Serket, Heater in the solo lane on Jonquil, and off the team, aka Kabam, on Ra. Puckum, though, could get caught out here. Looks like it's
Very
not going
late.
to happen. Just some group warding. I do want to mention Cheongga, we mentioned, is sort of a counterpick to Ra. But Ra's gonna be in mid and Cheongga's gonna be in solo. So that's some interesting situation for Zodiac, and it means that they're gonna have to be careful about when they get that Divine Ruin online.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, against a Jonquil in the solo lane, you can reduce his healing a little bit, but is it really worthwhile to rush a Divine Ruin in that situation, Crep?
Honestly, what it comes down to is if you rush Divine Ruin and finish it the wrong time, yeah, he doesn't heal for as much, but you don't do as much damage, so he wins the trades anyway. That said, if you get it maybe second or third after you finish your boots, it could be a little bit better for you. We'll see what Puckum intends to do, but it looks like this is going to be a normal start for both teams.
Yeah, just standard start overall. Gonna see a few early wards placed on the left hand side. No invasions coming out. Everyone starting where you'd expect to see them overall. Jonqui helping out Flawless there in the jungle. Bring down that speed buff for Sir Kett. Looking at the duo, say, in the solo lane right now, we will see Jonqui and Sir Kett match up against Chang'e and Loki. And it's a very similar situation there. Although if Sir Kett can find a great Cobra's Kiss here, correct, there is a potential for a quick early first kill.
Yeah, we'll see if that does end up happening. In the middle lane, Ra versus Yanis. Fairly even for now, but once Ra hits level 3, he can have very strong clear using his heal aggressively. In the duo lane, Thug Nasty and Kiwi Tiger pushing up to the edge of the tower. Unfortunately, Sobek really kind of prefers to be defensive in lane. He wants to pull you into his tower. When he's up against your tower, while he can pull you out of position, it's sort of if you miss a pull, you're gonna die.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those situations with Sobek where you're against a Geb, you're going to push the lane out anyway because of the fact that Geb's not the greatest lane pusher. I mean, he does have Ram with him, but Apollo's doing great work with Sobek here, pushing them in again. And you can see him going aggressive on this left-hand side as Thug Nasty tries to get some extra poke into the tower, force him under it. Right inside, though, Flawless goes to the jungle, gets a good Cobra's Kiss onto Loki. They're trading backwards and forwards here, and Flawless comes off worse for wear. Needs to be careful of the Chang'e rotation coming out, but both just going to back away. No kill just yet.
Yeah, Flawless is going back in though, drops that Deathbane. Now, something that people don't actually realize about Sir Kett is the way Catalyst works. We all know, you get two stacks and auto attack, and then you deal 10% max health as damage, which is great. Problem is, if you attack when you have one stack of the poison, it actually will still remove that stack, which means you want to use two abilities in succession, not auto attack between them, then auto attack to get that bonus damage. So you have to be very careful when you're fighting in these early fights because every little bit is super important.
It's one of those mechanical things about the god that makes it so difficult, because in a big team fight, Krat, making sure you don't just randomly auto attack the person you've applied a poison to can be very difficult in a big skirmish.
Yeah, and it also creates a meaningful choice between getting that 3 stack or auto-attacking between. That said, with the way people are currently building Sir Kett and the high crit, the auto-attack is probably better than the 10% health. That said, I haven't necessarily done the numbers. That's just got nice pull on Eclipseon, even nicer shield in the duo lane. That's exactly what we were talking about with this matchup. Kiwi Tiger is going to have a really tough time because Wubba is on point.
Buff mid lane has just reached level 5 now. We can see Ram is also level 5 and Loki's floating around the side here. Still only level 4 for the time being, but he's looking for an opportunity. But Geb spots that one out, so nothing's going to come from now. However, mid camp spawn in the next 15 seconds. We'll see a rotation to mid from Loki coming out here. We might see some aggression eventually from these two. He's just going to look to hit 5, ready for this mid camp start. Sobek already rotating over. We do get a kill in the solo lane, 1v1. That's big.
Yeah, it's going to be a big kill and should set the tone for the solo lane, but I'm more worried about what's going to happen at these mid camps. It's a 3v3. Sir Kett wants to go in. The invisibility. No, the ultimate will connect onto Loki.
Oh,
Snipe
combo
comes through, is not going to connect, but Cataclysm will do its job. Yanis portals through, but Loki gets taken down, and now Snapchat Gaming is forcing out their opponents.
Yeah, both very low in the middle lane right now. They're going to be able to rotate, get this left camp. I expect them to go for the right as well. However, it looks like Zodiac might need to be a bit careful here about rotating for this right one. All ultimates are down from Snapchat Gaming here, but the HPs are very low. Ambush over from Flawless, and Sobek quickly backs away, realizes he's not going to get anything out of it. But overall, that was really well played by Geb, considering the raw snipe did not land.
Yeah, that was just a little bit confusion with the combo coming out from Sir Kett, and that ultimate, honestly, is not as forgiving as Mercury. Yeah, left lane. Rollout doesn't connect directly into the ultimate. We'll be able to get out in time. That Apollo ultimate is down. He will return to base. It's still a victory for Snapchat Gaming.
Definitely.
It's just not what it could have been.
Definitely. A rollout for an ultimate is a fantastic trade all in all. So Snapchat Gaming in a pretty good position right now. Got both mid camps, picked up 2 quick kills. 1,000 gold lead and 2,600 experience lead at 4.5 minutes in the game. It's not bad at all.
Now, you play Hunter's Hindu Man, correct? Or Rama, at least.
I do play Rama, at least. Yes, that's the best way.
You know
way
that
it.
Feeling when you recall and you can't quite finish your devos, you just have to go to rank 2?
It's the worst. It's the worst feeling in the world, because you're going to go back to lane and you're going to get 500 gold in like a couple of waves, and you'll be like, I've got to go back to base again, but I've still got full HP and mana.
It's one wave for Apollo to get those devos finished. Really unfortunate timing for him there. He did have to go back. There was no safe way to farm because Rom's snipe was still online. So he's just gonna have to come in, take this wave, recall, finish his Devos. It's very important that he does go back to get the Devos again because he needs to start stacking ASAP. And we'll be recalling right about now. So unfortunate, but it's not going to set him too far behind.
Quick little look at the solo lane now, and you're gonna see Jeanqui a level lead thanks to that kill he picked up. Loki's over here, gets hit by the card though. Looks like he's gonna pop the ghost and try and trade this one back. Stun already used, forcing the assassinate away. Chonga's gonna take a brunt of this damage overall. She'll survive for now, but very weak, very low on mana, the blue buff's available. But the problem with this is it looks like she's going Divine Ruin as well, Kret, and this could be problems for her.
Yeah, I mean, we'll see what ends up happening within the next few minutes, but ganking Jeanqui can often be counterproductive because he's like, oh, you want to stand next to me so you can do damage to me? It's exactly where I want you to be. Oh, you want to use your escape ability to engage on me? That's perfect. Now you can't get away. And he's just able to tank out and deal that much damage, similar to Chalk, where they're just a little bit too tanky and too scary. It's the fact that they have trouble chasing you that stops them from being such a menace. When you engage, Zhong has fun.
Some nice work from Flawless in the jungle there. Realizing Loki was on the right-hand side, invaded on the left, put pressure onto Loki's camps, took away some harpies back there, and looking for rotations for the speed buff now. You can see a big group in a Snapchat trying to find this Yharnes in mid. It's not the easiest target to go on, and Sobek, well aware of this, rotates over as well. Loki's just waiting for his speed buff to come up. I expect an engage on these left harpies, though.
Yeah, Rom right now is sort of splitting the rotation. He's in range where he can ult if need be or get there very quickly. We'll have some trouble getting back in the lane, but this trade between Rom and Apollo should go the way of Eclipsium.
I'm not sure.
Getting pretty low. But actually, an engage on speed buff. Hold that thought. And it's going to be Immolation in a lot of trouble. Cataclysm comes through. Loki is going to go down.
Oh, it did force the out on Flawless, though. He didn't have to use it there to confirm it overall, but the speed buff also went over, thanks to Ra over the wall, off the team, with a great snipe, secures that speed buff, and it goes over to Flawless. Now, Yharnes, overextended here, needs to watch himself, gets hit by Cobra's Kiss, tries to get to the wall for the portal, but the Deathbane damage was just too much.
I love the way Flawless played that. First of all, I like that he ulted the Loki just because Loki has invisibility. He has an instant teleport ultimate. So no chances. Just get the kill, use the ultimate. I like the methodology. Rotate into the middle lane, and this is sort of maybe Deathwish not necessarily being used to the competitive scene. When your jungler gets ganked in the left jungle, it means that Snapchat is able to freely rotate back to mid, and Death just kind of got caught out in a situation where map pressure dictates he cannot stand there.
So 4-0 right now. You can see Loki rotating to the right-hand lane one more time, looking to put pressure on Jeanqui, who seems to be very comfortable in this lane right now. Having a good time. You can see Chonga has finished the Divine Ruin. Meanwhile, Jeanqui going back to base here when he can. Looks like he's going to stay for just one more wave, though, as Chonga's not letting him back. But a lot of pressure from Snapchat Gaming in mid lane.
Yeah, Snapchat is really exerting the pressure now. They're looking for invades or at least to clear timers in their enemy jungle. And they're putting priority on farming the Zodiac jungle and then just picking the Snapchat jungle up when it's convenient for them. Wubba, making the long rotation all the way over to the solo lane, will be able to pick up a lane of solo farm.
We saw a stage of the game now where the supports will start to roam even more. The hunters will be left alone to continue farming, get that experience they need. That solo experience is very important to them scaling into the late game. Overall, and Rama, very safe to do that, so Wubba quite happy to just start roaming around, pick up some free farm wherever possible, look for an opportunity to apply that Cataclysm pressure.
And it's going to be a shared speed buff clear, so now Wubba is really just trying to get as much experience as possible out of his team as a whole. He's also leaving Eclipteum by himself. That's a solo clear on the blue buff, whereas Apollo cleared it with three. So they're trying to exacerbate the lead that Eclipteum has over his opponent.
Ultimate comes out again. Double ultimate. Jeanqui pops his as well. There's the Exorcism, and the Deathbane applies the death that was required for Chonga. That's going to be some free time on the right hand side. Left hand side, though, Eclipteum got to be careful. Sobek's about. Not too much, though, but pressure applied. Just a quick roll away, and he's fine. Level 10 to the Sobek level 7.
Ooh, hold on. Red buff. That's going to be stolen away by Flawless22. Nice step in into Hog. Really, really good awareness there. Not even going to bother going for the kill. Kiwi Tiger, though. That's a great combo from off the team. Wubba secures the kill. No fantasy for challengers, but he definitely took that one for himself.
This is all down to the pressure they're exerting on mid. There's always somebody mid lane pushing Yarnus in, not allowing him to be able to rotate because he has to farm. And now they're going to look for the Gold Fury here. It's going to be uncontested. No wards to give vision of this. And with only Yarnus available to really rotate it, I can understand him not trying to contest.
Yeah, definitely. He didn't really have a good way to contest that. Maybe his best bet. And I actually would have liked to see him just throw an ult that direction and hope for the best.
The dream.
But with Hand of the Gods 3 on Geb, it's not likely. And, you know, it's really a shot in the dark. Snapchat just hit a really big breakpoint, though. They're sitting at 5,500 gold and 10,000 experience. Up until this point, they're really doing intelligent, concerted invades to apply pressure onto their opponents. They had to respect Zodiac's map pressure and they couldn't go over aggressive. Now it's really the point where they can just kind of do whatever they want, get super aggressive in the jungle, take every fight, and Zodiac has to find a way to respond.
Talking about it, they're looking to try and steal away this buff. Waxing Moon comes out from Chunga, trying to take a buff for herself. And now Loki's coming on the back with the Assassinate. It looks like he got some damage on top to Zonkui, but flawless. Zones out Chunga, and Chunga's the one that's going to be in trouble now without the Waxing Moon available. The card tick should be enough, and it's going to secure it. Sobek's late. Yarnus with the portal over, not going to be there in time. And you can already see Geb in a good position. Apollo's coming too, though. Can Apollo find something?
Yeah, Apollo on the ground, lands in the tower, will have aggros. This could be dangerous. Nice Cataclysm. The CC chain will result in the kill. Snipe comes through, and Kiwi Tagger is going to get picked up by Wubbo once again with the double.
Is that
gonna get the triple. Immolation is going to get poisoned onto his ally. Flawless just barely survives, and now it's Lone Yennis under tower in the left lane. Rama, AFKing and killing a tower.
I mean, that was all down to Snapchat trying to steal away the blue buff. Zodiac did not manage to... I think they got the blue buff, but they didn't make it pay. And now, Yarnus is in trouble as well. Force beads out once again from Wubba. They're going to get the tier 1 tower left. It looks like the right one's going to drop as well. That was a big fight for Snapchat. That's just really snowballed them even further in the lead.
I want to point out, Ecliptium is sitting 0-0-0 this game. Which is funny, because I think he's actually doing a really good job. He hasn't had to participate in kills because of where his team is applying pressure, but hold the thought, hold into tower. Kiwi Tagger played that well. Nice roll away, will drop some damage, and Thug Nasty isn't going to be able to chase. In fact, he might get taken down. Ecliptium trying to get his first kill. His ultimate is available. He goes up in the air. One shot miss, second shot miss, third shot.
That was max range. Max range. He couldn't get the last snipe off. He was at the maximum range he could be. But once again, the speed buff goes down again in favor of Snapchat. So once again, Loki denied. I mean, he's only level 9 right now. You can see Sirket level 13, a 4-level difference. And this is all down to Snapchat applying pressure mid and then rotating into the enemy jungle.
Yeah, totally. And, you know, the other thing to mention is they're able to rotate into the jungle because Loki's not good at fighting right now. A little weak in the jungle, but he can get the job done. We mentioned that versatility. But his early game and his clear isn't that great, so Immolation doesn't have a good way to recover. He needs his team to find really good fights, but now it might be a little bit too late for that. Red buff going to off the team on Raw, and he's going to be going into the double stack build. Warlocks into Thoth, which creates an incredible amount of magic power, pretty good health pool too.
Well, left mid-caps came up, left mid-caps way down in favor of Snapchat game, and you can see they want to rotate straight for the right-hand side. Wubba just applying dominance to the mid lane, just rolling out in the face, going, I'm going this way now, and there's nothing you can do about it. So more experience gained for Snapchat Gaming. They have to be very careful here, Team Zodiac, and position carefully, because once again, Snapchat want to invade the red.
Oh, but a big aggression on the right-hand side. Puckum having a lot of trouble again, and... it's just non-stop aggression from Snapchat. They're pressuring every lane, and right now they're making the transition from just getting money to getting more map pressure, which means towers. They want that left tower, they want that right tower, and I think
Buck up from Geb. He's going to be able to tackle huge amounts of damage. The Zonkui just stands there, popping ghosts, making people evaporate. Zonkui goes down. Sobek survives, but not for long as the Cobra's kiss Deathbane combo from Flawless picks him up. And now you see the rotation from Ecliptium on that Rama to mid lane. Looks like they want that tier 1 tower mid.
Yeah, they're going to force it. Looks like 4-on-2 right now as Apollo rotates back to left-hand side. And this is really important because the last mid tower, or sorry, the mid tower is the last bastion for Team Zodiac. It's the only thing giving them a good pressure on Goldfear and Fire Giant. But the jump in from Flawless, they're looking for Deathwish. He's going to get taken down. at mid tower will get tanked out and killed.
Is that Incon? Is he on a smurf right now? Like,
no, it's Matt Yankee, but he is. He's a very strong player. Maybe
4-0-6 Geb. Wow.
He's a multi-role player. We've seen him play ADC, jungle, support. Never really made it in high-level competition, but I feel like that's a little bit less skill and more attitude and opportunity. Wubba can definitely compete. He's also very high-ranked. I think high diamond right now.
Well, 13-0 in favor of Snapchat right now. 9,000 gold lead, 18,000 experience lead. And Zodiac looking for the Gold Fury. I think this is a desperation Gold Fury. They need it, though. They really need this to try and claw them way back in.
Yeah, they really need to make something happen here. Team Zodiac is running out of opportunity because at this point, the closeout for Snapchat is fairly straightforward. Take the objectives when they're up. Take towers when you don't have anything better to do. Keep the pressure on. And more than anything, picks mean Fire Giant. If they can get one, maybe two, but I think they could do it with just one. They can just walk over to Fire Giant and secure that essentially for free. Sobek isn't that great at stealing Fire Giants. He's really good at securing them, but when you have to walk in, you can have some trouble.
Well, right now the Gold Fury did drop for Snapchat Gaming one more time, and you're going to have to see Zodiac pull something out, but it looks like Apollo's been caught out of position, forced to use the Across Disguise to escape, and with the rotations coming in to support him, Raw nearly finds out Loki, forcing him away once again. You can just see the swarm of Snapchat now. They're just looking for a fight, looking for a pick to be able to get something more.
Clip Team just saw the recall from Apollo Thugnasty, and look at that. Team rotates in. This is a free tower. With Apollo not here, Snapchat Gaming can just take that objective. On the right-hand side, Yanis warning the Fire Giant. Really good use of the map pressure. All of Snapchat was on the left. Zodiac knew that. They need to get that ward on FG. So that was really the only safe time that they could do it.
Snapchat not going technically over-aggressive here. They're still trying to farm the mid-camps and get experience wherever they can. Left camps are up. You're going to see Flawless take those ones away. Rama rotating to the right ones right now. Chunga has pushed up the solo lane and it'll be farmed out by Ra sooner rather than later as she recalls back to base right now. I mean, what do you do right now, Krit, as Team Zodiac? Are you hoping for a Fire Giant pick here? You know, a steal? Is that what you're trying to hope for here?
What it comes down to when you're playing from behind like this, first of all, you have to wait for an opportunity. Because it's a 12k gold deficit, that's probably Snapchat Gaming making a mistake going for a Fire Giant that they can't really take for free, or trying to dive a Phoenix, or as Apollo's doing here, getting some opportunity to pressure that left-hand tower. His ultimate isn't available though. Nice meds. Flawless won't be able to get that kill. So nice play from Thugnasty. That's the kind of opportunity they need. It's going to be little sort of steps to pull them back into this game. That said, it's not looking good, and their chances of bringing it back are very low. It comes down to sort of waiting for either the small throws or the big throws.
Well, pressure once again from Snapchat Gaming on the right-hand side. They know the red buff's available. Meanwhile, left side, Rama trying to pressure this blue buff area right now, but he saw there was two. Going to rotate over to the mid lane. It looks like the Fire Giant is being harassed right now. They can see the members all grouped up at this red buff. Is Wubba going to make a play? The snipe does great damage to it. Does he manage to steal it away? He does. And Geb comes in to take it out.
Red buff. Geb, he has no magic power in his build, so that's going to be 12. Is 12
a lot
magic
of
power.
Damage. A lot of damage. That's what he's for. Well, Fire Giant missed started now. Flawless on zoning duty. Can't zone out Kiwi Tiger as he jumps to the ground, but Fire Giant's already dead. When he jumps up, I expect death. He's out and he's away straight away. The charge player clips himself, chasing onto him, looking for the damage. Meanwhile, on the backside of that, you're going to see Cobra's Kiss come out and kill off Deathwish as off the team secures that one. And Chunga's running through portals to the enemy jungle to try and live. Going to recall it, but back there, left-hand side, tier 1 tower does go to Apollo, but it doesn't look like Snapchat are done. They're grouping mid.
Hey, Apollo's going to look for a tier 2 here, but Serket has backed, and she can definitely force Apollo out. If anything, Wubba, hand off the team.
That was a show off. That was a show off
for that play. Yeah,
he just wanted to show off an ult. That's what it was. But left hand side, Flawless trying to defend against the Apollo aggression onto him. He takes the tower, but can he get away is the question. Well, Flawless going to continue the chase. He's got Deathbane. He's got ambush. It's going to be very easy to chase down. There's the ambush. There's the Deathbane.
Under mid Phoenix though, Heater's going to find a kill. Rom up in the air looking for the snipe. Gets it onto Loki. That's one Phoenix down. Middle one, pretty good. Left Phoenix, even better. because the further they are from the fire giant, the more pressure is exerted on the map. The heal hits the ground, and Flawless 22 is just farming the jungle. He knows he doesn't need to help his team right now.
Right now, left Phoenix falls. Only one Phoenix remains. Flawless pushing in the last tower that remains on the map for Team Zodiac. The rest of the team, though, grouping up at the Titan. They're considering starting this one. They're just buying time for Flawless to push in that side, I feel, right now. Maybe they'll go for the end here. They don't have fire minions just yet. But with the pressure they can put on with the heals from Ra, it looks like they're going to go for it. Curse comes out from Sobek. He charge plays back to base again. And there's a good waxing moon up. Three members. Loki going to go in, trying to find something out of this. One is low, but not low enough. Through space and time, connects him up, but Eclipse. Him cleans up Loki. He was just too low level to stay in the fight, and now he's gonna get onto Sobek. Is he gonna find a triple? Is he gonna find the quadra? That's the question. Now Chunga zooms out back to base, survives, and Kiwi Tiger picks up the kill thanks to the Titan helping out there. Looks like this one's going to Snapchat.
Snapchat is going to get a good trade there. It's two for actually, you know what? No, I'm gonna give that fight to Zodiac, and here's why. While it's a 3-for-2, so Snapchat got more kills, they're worth substantially more gold. So, Team Zodiac can take trades like that, and more than anything, stop them from losing the game. I mean, if more people had died, Snapchat might have taken the W. A little bit of overaggression there. It's not a comeback, but it's one of the first steps to, like, a throw that makes a comeback, if you know what I mean.
Well, they still have this tower remaining on the right-hand side. They're going to defend that. Apollo gone back to split, pushing left. Good thing about the fire minions now pouring in down this left-hand side for Apollo. He's going to be able to get free farm, get himself to level 20, and start working on his crit items, where he'll really start to come online. Meanwhile, across the way, though, Rama has already got his short sword online. We'll be finishing the rage sooner rather than later, I expect, on that one. Could actually sell off his death toll right now and finish that one off if he so chose. Right now, he's not going to do that, though. Going to leave base, and it looks like Snapchat are going to start grouping up and looking to push down this final tower.
Wubba on the right-hand side, clearing wards. Shockingly, has a more efficient ward clear than Chunga. One shockwave versus about three casts for Pac-Man. Or Puckum. But right now, Snapchat's just waiting. They're just going to clear the buffs, wait for Fire Giant to respawn, take it. If Zodiac contests, they lose that fight, or at least that's the plan. If they don't contest, then Snapchat's just going to push in, and since they have the opportunity, they're going to take a tower.
Tower's going to go down before anyone's going to try and group up. I think this Phoenix on the right hand side is going to be the final defense we see out from Team Zodiac. Can they make this one pay off for them? Apollo still split pushing left. Expect him to come in with the across disguise if he can get there in time when this fight happens. Here come the minions. Who's going to engage? Keep an eye on Wubba with the blink. There it is. He's going to go for the Cataclysm. Three members get hit, but one Avengers. The snipe was huge, and Ecliptian picks up one. There's the ghost coming out from Heater as well, and that's just going to evaporate the team. There's the across the sky from Apollo. But he's just going to return to his base and find out that it's a wreck. Your team has
destroyed a left. Across the sky is a great rotation tool, but when your team doesn't last for more than a few seconds, you're not able to get there in time. That was an instant initiation and instant kills. Nice mez out there, but it's not going to be enough to delay the kill on the Titan. Snapchat Gaming 24-2 at the 23-minute mark. We'll move on to the next round, which I believe is the round of 64.
Looking at how that one went for Snapchat Gaming, they look like contenders to be seen quite regularly, you know, in the coming weeks overall. It seems that they're a very strong team. They understand the importance of trying to deny jungle and invade and put pressure where you can. And it seemed to work out really well from that game.
Yeah, it really did. But, you know, I want to give some credit to Team Zodiac. They got pressured early and they couldn't take the fights, but they knew where to be. I think it was a little bit more of Snapchat pressuring Zodiac's team composition than Team Zodiac not knowing where to be and how to fight. When Snapchat went aggressive early in the jungle, it was just sort of, well, Serket's better right now than Loki is, so how are you going to contest that?
So Snapchat Gaming do move on to the round of 64. We'll be back with the next round as soon as the teams are ready.